I don't think so. I mean, I think that we haven't seen I showed you Chile and Argentina. We understand sort of like the macroeconomics of them, and we understand what makes emerging markets relatively more fragile. In the 90s, I developed this theory of the copy original sin, which is the fact that they borrow a lot in foreign currency, and then when they get into trouble, the currency weakens, so that it becomes more expensive, so that it becomes harder to pay, so the currency weakens, so that it becomes more expensive, and that's why they end up in these
Thank you. so much for inviting me and letting me share some words with you and some ideas. So unlike the last two talks, I'm not going to tell you about the collapse of any specific system. I'm going to do what Jeffrey's more interested in and tell you some toy models that give us some underlying mechanisms and insights into how things can fail. So I do study networks, and part of why I study networks is because I know that complex interdependent networks are the core of modern society. Social networks, biological networks, technological networks. And these networks are increasingly interacting with each other. They're increasingly cyber-physical, they're increasingly socio-economic. We can think, for instance, about, say, like a virus that's mutating on a biological gene regulatory network. That virus spreads over human contact networks. Those human contact networks have long-distance links enabled by critical infrastructure like airline networks. Those airline networks need all the information and communication technology for their scheduling and for their landing. So one simple example of disease spreading that we've seen has changed radically in the last millennia. It went from local spreading to now global pandemics. And of course, things like the power grid are a socio-technical system where human economic systems as well, where humans are moving and making all these decisions along with our automated traders. We're seeing a lot of mismatch in timescales and ability to process information quickly. So I've been studying a lot about networks for the last 20 years, but more of a theoretical perspective. And since everyone told me a story about SFI, I'll tell you the first time that I came to SFI was in 1996, when I was a PhD student at MIT and visited learning about cellular automata and thermodynamics. It was such a great community to be part of, and many of us realized around that time that the tools we had to stitch with us were giving us some kinds of machinery that we could use.
Failures. So how did I
I get into this? Why am I interested in interdependence between networks and cascading failures on interdependent networks? So part of the motivation is thinking about modern electric systems. So there's certainly a massive ecosystem. So this is a map of the United States where we've got three main electric regions, the Western Interconnect, the Eastern Interconnect, and Texas. And of course, we can also break this down into small